In this video, we're going to talk about whether it's okay to use a disconnect between a VFD and a motor. A quick answer here is yes, it is okay to use a disconnect, but there's a few things that needs to be considered before doing so. A couple of good things about using this, of course, is it gives the an additional safety for the user in the event that any kind of maintenance needs to be done on the motor side or on the output of the drive. And on top of that, the other things to consider as well is, in most applications, this is a very common thing to see, and this also will stop from any unintended operation. Even if there's a command on the drive side to run the motor, this will ensure that if any reason the motor should not be running, that is one way to stop it from doing so. Having said that, there are a few things that needs to be taken into consideration. One thing is, we do not recommend having the disconnect close while the drive already has power applied through the output side with a command enabled. Because what will happen with that particular scenario is it will cause a slamming effect. Now, slamming is where the output of the VFD with 480 volt, if it's assuming it's running at that particular speed, is going to cause an undue burden, undue stress on the IGBT components. Because these components that aren't designed to run across the line with full power applied to the load, which is going to cause a huge amount of current spike as well. And of course, in doing so, it may cause the VFD to fail prematurely, possibly. So you want to make sure that if you are using a disconnect, that it's closed before running the VFD. Now, in some cases, it's been known that adding a fast-acting auxiliary contact on the disconnect via a permissive functionality is a good idea, because again, that will ensure that the drive won't run unless that permissive and the run command is made, which means that the contact will already be closed before the run command will be active on the VFD. So with that being said, an example of the things you can that I just mentioned here regarding a permissive, looking at the ATV630 VFD here using the SOMOV software, just as a reference to what we just mentioned. On a 630 drive, things like a freewheel stop assignment is a good idea to use. So for that kind of functionality, you can go to parameter list, generic functions, and then you can go to stop configuration, and here you have the freewheel stop assignment here. So I mentioned you can program this input to a logic that is needed here, and again, what will happen is, unless that logic is active, it will stop you from running the VFD even if the main run command is active. Again, this is something that has to be controlled through this disconnect at the motor or between the drive and the motor. Another thing to consider as well is, a lot of times you may decide that you want to achieve a freewheel stop, because when you give it a stop command the VFD, what it does is it decelerates down to zero. It doesn't just go ahead and go from 100 to zero speed in less than a second. It actually decelerates based upon the deceleration time that is seen in the simply start menu. And normally from a factory it's at 10 seconds, but again, it's adjustable to what the application calls for. So in the event that you don't want any control of the VFD during a deceleration time, what you can choose to do as well is to go under generic functions, and you can go under the stop configuration again, and you'll notice that the type of stop from a factory default is on ramp. So in the event that you don't want any control of the motor during a stop mode, you can go ahead and set that to freewheel stop, which again may help you not have any interference to when that disconnect is opened or closed, to when that command is active. So hopefully this sheds a little bit more light on whether it's okay to use a disconnect between a VFD and a motor on our Altivar drives.